And so overall, the Tigershark Fighter Bomber is an interesting and valuable component of the Tau arsenal, owing to the fact that it has two heavy burst cannons plus all of its other weapons, but that's balanced out by the fact that it has all the shortcomings of flyers. So there's really this cost-benefit analysis that has to go into whether you're going to take Tigersharks or Riptides and the balance that you strike between those two. So what's that? Oh, there's a new FAQ? Awesome. What'd they change? Oh. All right, so I had been holding off on doing my Tiger Shark review for the Codex because I had a feeling that it might be addressed in the FAQ, and turns out that I was right. So if you're not familiar or not up to date on the whole deal, basically the Tiger Shark Fighter Bomber had two heavy burst cannons on it. And when the Codex got updated, that indirectly updated the heavy burst cannon entry for the Tiger Shark as well, making it, like I said, a really nice balance between the benefits of having a greater output at a higher ballistic skill than a Riptide, but also having the weaknesses of not quite as much durability, plus being a flyer, not being able to cap objectives and everything like that. And so there's this nice nuance associated with the decision of Riptides or Tiger Sharks. Now, in the latest FAQ, they basically removed that nuance for you and relabeled all of the heavy burst cannons on the Tiger Shark to be Swift Strike burst cannons instead. So they are a completely different entry, and they retain the old heavy burst cannon profile. So not quite as good as the Riptide version, but still not bad. So today we're going to talk about what the Tiger Shark Fighter Bomber can do post Big FAQ 2 and how you might want to use one in your army. In general, the Fighter Bomber is moderately durable, pretty darn fast, and can pack a punch against a wide diversity of unit types. This is something that distinguishes it from the AX-10, which I've reviewed previously, link in the description, but the AX-10 is much more specialized than the Fighter Bomber. So Fighter Bomber has a lot more options and can, you know, pack a punch against a wider set of opponents. And so that's really where the nuance of the Fighter Bomber comes in. Basically, the Fighter Bomber has a pretty good movement stack. It can go from 20 to 75 inches at full health, which is 16 wounds at toughness 8 and a 3-up save. It also has a 5-up invulnerable save, plus the goodies of being a flyer, so minus 1 to hit. So, you know, pretty hard to take down with just run-of-the-mill weaponry, but it won't be on the board forever if your opponent really wants it gone. So it can disappear fairly quickly if the opponent has the appropriate tools, like most units. Now, what really makes the Tiger Shark Fighter Bomber stand out are its weapons, and it has quite a few options. So we'll kind of go through the list here, get the easy stuff out of the way. It can take up to 6 Seeker Missiles. You should always do this. Seeker Missiles are a fantastic value, and if you can take 6 of them, you should definitely do that. It has a ballistic skill of 2 up at full health, which also helps it leverage all of its other weapons, but especially on Seeker Missiles, once we're able to get our marker lights on a target, having that 2 up ballistic skill is really going to make a difference. So this is one of the best platforms for Seeker Missiles between the Tiger Shark or something like a Hammerhead with Long Strike. Those are going to be your best ways to get Seeker Missiles out. And, hey, that's what we're talking about right here. So Seeker Missiles on Tiger Shark are a must. The second option that you have is that you can either have a transport bay that can help you transport drones, or you can switch this out for 2 Sky Spear Missile Racks. The transport ability does have some utility, mainly because it prevents you from, or rather substitutes the ability to Manta Strike your drones. You don't actually have to put them in Deep Strike, meaning that you could potentially drop drones directly on top of an enemy to support a unit that's in peril, or to unload a bunch of shots. Now, really, I think the best way to deal with that is just kind of not expect that to happen, or at least, you know, plan around it and have your drones either already on the board or Deep Strike in at a safe distance. But overall, I think the transport option here has a use, but it's outweighed by the benefits that you get from having the Sky Spear missile racks. Now, those are basically real heavy burst cannon shots. They are D6 shots, so you don't get a whole lot of shots necessarily, but you do have two of these, so 2D6 shots, strength 6, minus 2 AP, 2 damage. So you do retain some of that offensive capability that's going to be really good against anything with a little bit of armor or even a lot of armor. That's going to make a difference, just like your normal Riptide shots. And these, again, are at Ballistic Skill 2, and if you are using your marker lights, you don't suffer penalty for moving. So really a nice weapon there. So again, go with the missile racks. Now, the real thing that comes into question with how you should play a fighter bomber is what are its main weapons. And you have three options. You can either do the now renamed Swift Strike Burst Cannon, which is strength 6, minus 1 AP, 1 damage, or you can go with a Swift Strike Railgun, or with ion cannons. And the ion cannon and the railgun options are kind of two sides of the same coin in terms of what they're meant to do. And so we'll start with the ion cannon and kind of work our way back. All right, so if we're looking at this from a point efficiency standpoint, where we look at the total number of wounds we would expect based on the entire loadout against a unit of any particular stat line, per point spent on that unit, we see that the ion cannon really is not a strong choice. The main competitor that we're going to have with the Tiger Shark with ion cannons is a Hammerhead with ion cannons, and the Hammerhead is just more points efficient than a Tiger Shark. So really what we want to do then is, if we're looking to bring ion cannons, stick with Hammerheads instead. Now, this doesn't take into account any type of durability issue here, so you might want to go with the Tiger Shark because it is a flyer, because it has minus one to hit, and because it has a 5-up invulnerable save. That might become more valuable to you if you're losing your Hammerheads left and right. But if we're looking at just a offensive output per point, the Hammerheads win. So we should go with those in that case. If we look at the Swift Strike Railgun, for example, that's actually the opposite. So here the Tiger Shark is actually more efficient than Hammerheads, even with Long Strike. So the Swift Strike Railgun is heavy 2, strength 8, minus 4 AP, D6 damage, and then it has the normal Railgun mechanic. So you know, a fair amount of damage that can be done here, especially against higher strength, higher toughness units, ones with invulnerable saves. The railgun is actually going to do fairly well, and being on the Tiger Shark, you're going to get more out of it than if you bought the equivalent points worth of Hammerheads. So that's, you know, good news, bad news type of thing, right? Where things get to be a little bit more interesting is when we look at the heavy burst cannon option. So no longer being the heavy burst cannon is now the Swift Strike burst cannon, and comparing that to Riptides with actual heavy burst cannons, which one is a more efficient choice? And it turns out that unless it has an invulnerable save, unless you're targeting something with an invulnerable save like a knight, you are going to be better off taking a Riptide. Riptides are going to be about 20% more points efficient than a Tiger Shark when taking out units without an invulnerable save. So if you are expecting to see something with an invulnerable save, the Tiger Shark still has a place, but it's a very niche choice because of that. You really need that invulnerable save to be present to make the Swift Strike more efficient than the Heavy Burst Cannon. Now, the reason for this is because with the Heavy Burst Cannon, we're assuming that we're going to be taking an advanced targeting system, so it's really AP minus 2, and yes, that's accommodated for or accounted for in the actual point cost that I'm attributing to the Riptide, so don't worry about that. But either way, when we look at it, the Riptide is going to be more efficient against things without an invulnerable save, just because it has a suite of traits that allow it to actually do more damage when it can actually leverage those AP characteristics. When there's an invulnerable save in place, then the Tiger Shark, having more guns that don't have high AP on them, actually gets the upper foot, because it can actually do the same amount of damage. It's not really that influenced by the fact that there's an invulnerable save, and so the point efficiency on the Tiger Shark actually wins out when there is an invulnerable save. So all that said, we can kind of look at the rankings of the different Tiger Shark options against the competitors. So overall, I think the Tiger Shark still isn't quite as good as a Riptide, so I would go with Riptides still being number one. But then depending on the situation, the Tiger Shark can be better than a Hammerhead. So you have this kind of in-between positioning between a Hammerhead and a Riptide where you find the Tiger Shark. Now, there are a couple other options that you have. Basically, you have the option of taking burst cannons or cyclic ion blasters on the turrets. Go with the cyclic ion blasters. You're really going to try to leverage as much as you can out of this model, so you might as well take cyclic ion blasters and leave the strength 5 shots to your fire warriors or something like that. And then additionally, it comes equipped with two missile pods as well. So a little bit, you know, a little sprinkle of missile pod on top, just like the Barracuda. Overall, you know, yeah, I think that the Tiger Shark suffered a lot with Big FAQ 2. It still has a role, but it's not as competitive as it was a month ago when it had the heavy burst cannon with the Riptide standard rules. So for that reason, I probably am going to shy away from using a Tiger Shark, but I still think that it has some value, which is probably pretty good considering I have this to work with now.
Hey everyone, thanks for watching. This video is made possible by my supporters over on Patreon. If you enjoyed this video, consider joining our community over there. Special thanks to Max Harrison, Aaron Fox, Jared Egler, Nick Steele, Tao Oswell, Brian Mann, Stephen Cohen, Jake Johnson, Eric Jackson, Tim Piney, Yuhai Penguin, Benjamin, Andy M. Young, Peter Benjamin Parker, Julian Peck, RP, and Giovanni DiMaggio.